Okay, now let's move on to what they say is putting our money where our mouth is. Every time there's an incident in the West Philippine Sea, you have lawmakers, you have the executive, of course, spewing out their condemnation when it comes to China's aggressions. But at the end of the day, it's really about equipping the Philippine Coast Guard, equipping the Navy, because they do patrol those seas. The modernization of the armed forces is a bigger issue compared to just really what's at hand, the Philippine Coast Guard and the Navy. So I'll start with this first. The confidential funds for the 2024 budget are now at 10.1 billion pesos, of which 4.5 billion is proposed for the office of the president. And actually, you're right, Senator Pimentel. DepEd proposal is still it's at 150 million pesos, and the office of the vice president is at either five, is it at 500 or 600?
I think 500.
500 million.
Yes.
Then you have the Philippine Coast Guard. Nananawagan po sa Head Start. Ang confidential funds ng Coast Guard is 10 million pesos. Hindi man lang isang daang milyong piso. So you have civilian agencies like the DepEd
Right.
with 150 million. And the vice president said education is intertwined with national security. It's important for us to mold children who are patriotic. They're children who can't read. And yet you have the Coast Guard at 10 million.
Right. We will bring this up, Karen, during the budget deliberations. Ako kasi I'm not a big fan of giving agencies which have nothing to do with law enforcement, public order, or national security, the so-called CIF, confidential and intelligence funds. And then the Philippine Coast Guard is definitely involved in law enforcement, public order, and national security. So we have an open mind in granting the PCG, Philippine Coast Guard, CIF, but up to a reasonable amount. Ibang debate na po yung totally civilian agency not involved in law enforcement, and yet getting CIF or asking for CIF and getting a tremendous amount. Iba na, so dalawang issues po yun. Well, whether you should give, and then the reasonableness of the amount that you have given as CIF.
And I wanted to say, of course, this isn't against a specific person. This is not
As a
against a
principle.
person, of the vice president as DepEd secretary. But according to Senator J.V. Ejercito, ang nangyayari, you have na other civilian agencies that are asking for confidential and intelligence funds. Sabi nga niya, parang nawiwili rin. Kasi kung meron ang DepEd, ba't di sila?
Last year ko pa sinabi yan, Karen.
Oo.
Sabi ko, meron akong dalawang ahensya. Sabi ko, first time kayong makakakuha ng CIF, huwag nyo nang umpisahan. Kasi nga, pag naumpisahan ninyo, nakatingin din yung ibang civilian agencies, bakit sila meron, hingi rin kami. So talaga, mauuso po yan. Especially
Oo.
when, mauuso talaga yan, especially when we have found a way to justify the grant of CIF, which is not justifiable. Because yun ang purpose ng CIF eh. The agency must be involved in law enforcement, public maintaining public order, or national security. That's why you need to give them flexibility because there are expenses or expenditures which are not normal for these agencies.
Is the confidential and intelligence funds, have they become more of political accommodation through the years? Do you see that, Senator?
Well, dito siguro sa office of the vice president because it's such a large amount. It's such a large amount. And then I think the former vice president did not ask for, demand for, or avail of CIF.
Mm-mm. And to be fair, during the end of Vice President Binay, I also saw a chart. I think he had a small amount in the beginning, parang 10 million, ang maliit lang. Parang ganon, tapos yan towards the end. 5 million, no? Kay VP Binay noon, maliit lang. And then towards the end, he didn't even already have.
Yes. So nawala. Kaya nga, even if it was started, let's say, once upon a time, in the office of the Vice President, the practice was not continued.
Mm-hmm.
And now, sana, and then we brought it back, and we brought it back at such a large amount. Yun na nga, that's why it's doubly objectionable.
Mm-hmm.
So sana nga, we will appeal once again. We will repeat the arguments or the statements we have made last year. We'll repeat them. So tignan natin, maybe the effect now would be different.
Mm-mm. All right. Well, on that note, I just also wanted to ask you, when it comes to the 2024 budget, we are hitting, I mean, there's been quite an increase. We have debts now that are at 14 trillion. That's the latest. Our debt to GDP is at 65%, which the finance secretary has said on Head Start, it's still okay. So that's what he said. What would you want to see in the 2024 budget as you study it?
Well, if we are...
Focus on where?
We have to focus on sensible indigenous funds to bloat the amounts unnecessarily. Mm-hmm. So we have to spend now on sensible items and prioritize. So anong ibig sabihin ito? Priority, pagkain. Doon na lang, pagkain. Yung iba kasi, Karen, I've noticed some agencies, they feel the itch to spend. So what do? They think of a new logo, a new slogan, para lang makagastos. Eh, sabi ko nga, advice ko, if you feel the itch to spend, donate the amount to agriculture. Let's produce more food. Nakatulong pa tayo to bring down inflation. Productivity is the formula against in fighting inflation. So ganun po yun. Let's be sensible with our expenditures.
All right. Well, on that note, I want to thank you for joining me today. It's always an honor to have you on Head Start. Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel, maraming salamat po sa inyo, Senator.
Salamat din, Karen.